All right, now we begin indicator two, and indicator two, the first part is converting rational numbers. And as you can see, the learning target, I can convert decimals to fractions, I can convert fractions to decimals, and I can solve problems using terminating or repeating decimals and complex fractions. Okay, so this is all part of indicator two, converting rational numbers. There are certain vocabulary words that you are going to learn. Bar notation, rational number, repeating decimal, and terminating decimal. These are the different terms or vocabulary that you are going to run across, okay? So if I look at the vocabulary over there, let's talk about what a rational number is. We know that we have done that integers are a set of whole numbers and their opposites. So a rational number is a number that can be written as A divided by B. This is how a rational number can be written, where A and B, these are your integers. Okay, A and B are integers, all right? And B is not equal to zero, okay? So that's what a rational number is. So once again, an integer is a set of whole numbers and their opposites. And so rational number is one in which you can write A over B in that format, and A and B are integers, where your B, which is your denominator, is not a zero, okay? So then we have, so because you can divide any integer by any non-zero integer, you can use long division to write fractions and mix numbers as decimals. And these decimals are rational numbers, and they will either terminate or they will repeat. Okay? So a terminating decimal is a decimal that ends. Okay? A decimal that ends. So for example, I can give you 1 5/10. All right, that's the terminating decimal. Negative 2,500, that's a terminating decimal. Okay, 10 824 thousandths, that's a terminating decimal because it is a decimal that ends. Okay, a repeating decimal is a decimal that has a pattern that repeats. Okay, so if I give you something like negative 1 3/10, and if it's repeating, I'm going to have the bar notation on the top like this. That tells me that number 3 is going on and on and on and on, continuing without ending. So that's why it's called a repeating decimal, okay? If I give you something like 1,500 and this, with the bar notation over 1 5, that means those digits are repeating in that order constantly, all right? So I'm gonna have 1 5 1 5 1 5 1 5 repeating in the decimal place value over there. So that's what a repeating decimal is, okay? So now that we've understood the vocabulary of this, let's continue with some problems that we are going to solve using this, all right? So, please remember again, a rational number is basically nothing. Is any fraction can be expressed as a decimal by dividing the numerator by the denominator, okay? And the decimal form of a rational number is called a repeating decimal. And repeating decimals can be written using bar notation. That's if the numbers are repeating. All right, so this is a repeating one, and then you have the terminating one, all right? But this basically means what? This means this, continuing. All right, so that is what that actually means, okay? So, all right, now we're going to write decimals. You're going to write a fraction into a decimal, all right? So if I give you, now we're having this knowledge, we are going to now convert fractions to decimals, this part. Okay? So if I give you, let's say I give you the fraction 1/40th, okay? If I say this is your fraction and convert this to a decimal, all I basically have to do is I have got to just, this actually means nothing, but I'm taking the numerator and dividing it by the denominator. All right, taking the numerator and I am dividing it by the denominator. Okay, now we have done and mastered division, especially where decimals are involved. So I know the decimal is going to go behind the whole number. Okay, and then the first step we've learned is decimal above decimal for the quotient so that we know exactly where it's placed and do not make any mistakes. Okay, so now, can I divide 1 by 40? No, so I'm going to put a 0 here. Okay, and then basically that means what? Minus 0 times this, this is basically what I'm doing. Right, so now I'm going to annex a 0 and bring it down. Okay, can I divide 10 by 40? No, it's still smaller. So I'm going to put a 0. Okay, and again, now what is going to happen is times here, 0, and I get 10. All right, annex another 0. And now I look at how many times 40 is going to give me 100 or less. So that is 2 times 40 gives me 80. And I get 20. And I annex a 0. Okay, and I can look at this and I know that 5 times 4 is 20, right? So I get 200 because 5 times 4 is 20, 5 times 0 is 0, and I get 0 remainder. So therefore, my answer in this case is going 1/40th is equal to 25,000th as a decimal. 25,000 as a decimal. And I've already taught you how to read decimals, place value. So just going to quickly refresh that in your brain. Already, you know, when we did this in the past, you put a little one under the decimal and you look at this. And so it's telling you 1,000. So that's 1,000th place value because everything behind the decimal place value is 1,000th. Okay. So, and we don't have a 1th. There's no such thing. We have ones, but not one. So this 10th, this is 100, this is 1,000. So 25,000th would be the answer to this problem. Okay? Let's go ahead and do another problem in which we are writing the number. So this basically, the first one that we did, this terminated, right? So therefore, this one is a terminating decimal. This is a terminating decimal. All right. Now, let's try another one. And we'll see if we are getting terminating or not. Okay. So let me just get this out of the way. All right. So my question, -5/6. All right. So once again, I am going to, take the numerator. And I know that my answer finally is going to be negative because negative divided by positive. Okay. So 5 divided by 6, decimal behind the whole number, decimal above decimal. I cannot do this. 0 times 6 is 0. I get 5. Next, I annex a 0 and I bring it down. Okay, and then I know that 8 times 6 gives me 48 and I get 2 remainder. And then I annex a 0, bring this down. And I get 3 times 6 is 18. And I get 2 remainder, annex a 0, bring it down. Look what's happening, 20. All right, again, 3 times 6, 18. And 2, annex a 0. So this goes on endlessly. All right, And I can see that the three is constantly repeating when I am doing this problem at the end. So I am going to put a bar notation above the three. Okay, instead of writing it like this, we're not writing it like this. We're not writing this and this, this. I mean, that's correct, but the best way to show this is with a bar notation. This is telling me three is constantly going on. So negative 5/6 is equal to negative 8300 with the repeating sign over the 300. Okay, over the 300. So this is a repeating decimal. This is a repeating decimal. All right. So as you can see, the difference between the two over here, it ends. But this one continues. All right. So that's what a repeating decimal is. All right. Let's do another one and see if you're getting a terminating decimal or a repeating one. So, all right. So let me give you negative 3/11. So once again, this answer is going to be negative because I can see the negative in the front, or I can also write it like this, all right? So I'm gonna get a negative quotient when I divide, all right? So, if I divide 3 by 11, decimal here, does not go, it's smaller. So then I can annex a 0, all right? And then 2 times 11 gives me 22, all right? And then I get 10 minus 2, because here I borrow, this becomes 10 minus 2, this gives me 8. And this is, of course, 2 minus 2 is 0. All right, annex is 0, bring this down. And so 7 times 11 is going to give me 77. Again, I'll have to borrow. This becomes 10, this becomes 7. 10 minus 7 is 3. Okay, again, annex is 0. All right, and then I can see 2 times 11 is 22. Again, 8. Again, 0. So this pattern, as you can see, I'm going to get 7, 77. Again, I get a 3. So this is continuing. So the digits that are constantly repeating are 2700. So I would write this is equal to negative 2700. And both of them are going to have the bar notation on the top because what is happening? 2727, this continues, all right? And so this is a repeating decimal. That is a repeating decimal, okay? So let's do one where we have a mixed number and we are gonna write it as a decimal. So let's say I gave you -2 1/4, -2 1/4, and I said write this as a decimal. There are two ways I can do this, all right? Either I can convert it to an improper fraction and then divide, or I take the whole number out, I just divide the fractional part and then combine them at the end. So I'm going to show you both, okay? So I know that my answer is going to be a negative answer because I have negative 2 over here, all right? So 2 times 4 is 8, so we multiply and we add in order to make it an improper fraction. 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1 is negative 9 over 4, okay? And then I just divide 9 by 4. My decimal goes here. Okay, so 2 times 4 is going to give me 8, and I have 1 remainder. Okay, and then I annex a 0, bring this down. Again, I have 2 times 4 is 8, and I get 2. Annex a 0, bring this down. 5 times 4 is going to give me 20. and I get zero remainder, and this is terminating. So this gives me, my answer is negative 2 and 25 hundredth. Okay, so this is one way of doing it. And then another way that I was mentioning is, all I do is I take the decimal part, which would be the fractional part, is the decimal part. Since I'm saying a negative 2 and 1/4, okay, I know it's going to be negative 2. That's the whole number part, okay? And the decimal goes here, and I know that 1/4 is a quarter, right? Which would be 2,500. So 2,500, and that is what my answer is going to be. Basically, I could have just done 1 divided by 4, just the fractional part, okay? And don't forget to put the whole number part. That's the mistake people make, all right? Decimal above decimal, 0. Okay, I get 1, and x, 0, 2 times 4, 8, 2, and x is 0, 5 times 4 is 20. So look, same thing. I am just dividing out the fractional part, and then I attach it back to the whole number part. And so this is a way that you can do your mixed numbers and convert them to decimals, okay? Let's do... a problem now. We are writing a terminating decimal as a fraction now. Now we are going to write a terminating decimal as a fraction. Okay? So any terminating decimal, that means a number which is ending. For example, this is the terminating decimal. Okay? So any terminating decimal can be written as a fraction whose denominator is a power of 10. You can often simplify the resulting fraction by dividing out any common factors, which is the same as removing the common factor from the numerator and the denominator, okay? So, let me give you an example, all right? Let's say I give you a terminating decimal, which is 4,800. As I can see, I don't have any bar notation, all right? So all I need to do in this case is to be able to read it. So if I have this written out, I've taught you how to read it, right? So that means 4,800. Since it's 4,800, how I read it is how I'm going to write it. So this basically means 48 over 100 as a fraction. And then we talked about simplifying it, right? So all we're doing is we are going to take these numbers and, well, we can find the greatest common factor. So write the numerator and denominator. Use the greatest common factor method, all right? So both are even numbers. They are divisible by 2. All right, so I get 24 and I get 50. Both are still even numbers, so I can simplify more. And I get 12 and I get 25. Right? So this is going to be 12/25 as a fraction in simplest form. So you're taking a terminating decimal and converting it to a fraction in simplest form. Make sure however you read it, that's how you write it. That's how many zeros you're going to have in the denominator. And then you're going to simplify it, okay? So let's try another one. If I say negative 2600, negative 2600, all right? So all I'm going to do over here, since I'm saying 2600, that's how I'm going to write it. And I know that my answer is going to be negative because of this. All right. So this is negative 2600. Okay. And then I simplify and I can divide 26 and 100 both by 2. Okay. So if I divide by 2, or I'm simplifying over here. All right, I'm going to get negative 13 over 50. Negative 13 over 50. And this is my decimal as a fraction in simplest form. Okay. Let's do. Okay. If I have a mixed number, all I'm doing is I am taking the mixed number, and again, I have the whole number part and I have the fractional part, basically, as I just showed you how to solve it. Okay. For example, writing a decimal as a fraction or mixed number in simplest form, let's say I give you, negative 3 1/10, or I give you a negative 10 25/100, and it's saying write this as a fraction, write this as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so I know after the decimal I have this and I have this, right? So this is negative 3 1/10. So this is my fraction in simplest form. All right, this one is negative 10 25/100. Look, right? And so once I have 2500, I know this is divisible by 25, and that is negative 10 1/4, which is my decimal as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so that's how we do the mixed number part. Let's go to a problem where I have repeating decimals. Okay, so let's go to a problem where I have a repeating decimal, and we are going to write that as a fraction in simplest form. Okay, so let's say my repeating decimal is this. I'm going to teach you a formula which is very easy to convert any repeating decimal to a fraction. All right, so the formula for this is dn, all right, times f minus nrp over d. All right, so D is, this is my decimal number. This is my decimal number. Okay, decimal number, which I can see is 5/10 over here. All right, F is like if there is one repeating part or one repeating number for one, it's going to be 10. Okay, for one repeating, it will be 10. For two repeating, it will be 100. For three repeating, it will be 1,000, etc. Okay, that F, basically we are trying to get rid of that decimal. So if there's one repeating, you do times 10. If it's two repeating, you do times 100. If it's three repeating numbers, you are going to do times 1,000. Okay, minus, this is my non-repeating part. Non-repeating part. Now in this problem, I do not have a non-repeating part, but I will show you a problem soon where there is a repeating, non-repeating part. Okay, and D is for like if there is one number that's repeating. I have 9. Okay, this is 9 if one number is repeating. Okay, if two numbers are repeating, then it's going to be 99 if two numbers are repeating. Okay, so here you go. 999 if three numbers are repeating. And so then this carries on in that way, depending on how many numbers are repeating. Okay, so let's use this formula and quickly solve this problem. So as I can see, in this case, my dn, the decimal number, is going to be 5/10. Okay, since one number is repeating, it's going to be times 10. There is no non-repeating part. So if this was 1 and then 5 repeating, then it would be minus 0.1. But there's no non-repeating part over here. So minus 0 over D, this is like 9 if there's one number repeating. So there's one number repeating only. So this is going to be over 9. Now, when I'm multiplying something by 10, the decimal moves one place to the right. So this is going to become this, right? So this becomes 5 minus 0 over 9. So therefore, my decimal into a fraction is going to be 5 ninth. All right, so that's how simple this is going to be. All right. Let's try this one more. Okay, so let's try, let's say I change this question to negative 7 with the repeating the bar notation over the 7/10. So all I'm doing now again, same thing, since one number is repeating, I'm going to do 7/10. Remember, the answer will be negative at the end because it's starting with a negative. All right, but I'm just going to use the formula times 10 because I have to move this one. There is no non-repeating part in this, and since we have only one number repeating, it's over 9. Okay, so this 7/10 times 10 is going to become 7, so negative 7/9 is my answer in the simplest form. Okay, now let me show you this one. This is a little bit up one level, but I wanted to show you when a number does have a repeating part so that we can apply that. So let's say I give you 1300 with only the 3 repeating. Okay, so we are going to change this to a fraction in simplest form. All right, so I start with this. My decimal number is 1300, right? That is the decimal part, times what is the fractional part that is repeating. Okay, only one is repeating. So because only one is repeating, I'm going to do times 10. If both were repeating, I would do times 100. But since only 3 is repeating, I'm going to do times 10 minus the non-repeating part. The non-repeating part is just this portion, which is 1/10. Okay? So minus 1/10. Okay? And now we know that what is happening, that only one number is repeating. Since only one number is repeating, I am going to write over 9. Okay? And now what do I get? If I do this and I multiply with 10, this is my number, right? 1 3/10. So I get 1 3/10, okay? Minus the non-repeating part, which is 1/10 divided by 9. Okay, so 1 3/10 minus 1/10. Okay, that's going to give me 1 2/10 over 9. 1 2/10 over 9. And in order for me to convert this decimal into a whole number on the top, I have to multiply the numerator and the denominator with 10. Okay, so then I'm going to move this one place to the right. And then if I move one place to the right, my number is going to be 12 over 90. And then I am just going to simplify. Okay, and when I simplify 12 and 90, let's see, I can do it over here. If I do 12 and I do 90, and I start simplifying, both are even numbers, I can start with 2, right? And I get 6 times 2 is 12. Right, and I have 45 times 2 is 90, and then I can see that both of these are divisible by 3. Okay, so 2 times 3 is 6, and 15 times 3 is 45. So my fraction in the simplest form is going to be 2/15. 2/15. All right. So that was how you convert your repeating decimals to fractions in simplest form. I really like this formula. It is very easy. This is what I teach math team also, because they do have a lot of problems where repeating decimals have got to be converted into fractions in simplest form. All right. So are we completed our learning target of converting decimals to fractions and fractions to decimals? And solving problems using terminating or repeating decimals. We'll be getting more into complex fractions in the next lesson. All right, have a great day, y'all.